Ever since the beef between Mike Hoffman's girlfriend and Erik Karlsson's wife, Erik Karlsson found himself now in a defensively stacked Sharks team. Because he is a two-time Norris Trophy winner, and because he's Erik Karlsson, we expected big things. It was not an easy fit for Karlsson, to say the least, and his season would be over before it had even begun. And the hype has seemingly died for Karlsson. He was a frontrunner for the Norris at the start of the 2019-2020 season, and I think people should be saying the same thing this year. Hey guys, Cruiser here. Today we're going to look at the redemption of Erik Karlsson and the proof that he's still going to put himself in the conversation for the Norris. Leave a like and subscribe if you enjoy the video. It really helps me out. Let's go. For the past forever, it seems that the Sharks have been a playoff team for a long time. The Sharks would only miss the playoffs twice in the last 20 years, but the San Jose Sharks would come to a crashing halt last season, finishing at the bottom of the West and the third worst team in the NHL with just 29 wins. But now San Jose is going to come back in a big way, because Erik Karlsson is going to prove the NHL that he's a true superstar, and that he's an alpha dog. Yes, I said alpha dog, because let's go back to 2017, when Karlsson was able to single-handedly will his Ottawa Senators to the Eastern Conference Finals. He would get 62 points in 71 games. It would almost get the MVP trophy, but I am just going to say it. After Karlsson joined the Sharks and put up some impressive numbers with 40 points and 45 points in both seasons, he seemed to have dropped off from his Ottawa days, turning into a more one-dimensional player. By that I mean, he's only really able to play offense now, instead of back in Ottawa when you would see him make incredible defensive stops. But that is all about to change. Recent reports from Doug Wilson, the GM of the Sharks, just said, you're going to see Erik Karlsson be one of the most dominant players in the game again. And he followed that up with, it might be the first time he's been 100% healthy since he's been with us. And Doug Wilson will continue to say the reason that Erik Karlsson had such a bad season, even though he got 45 points in 50 games, was because he had just undergone a surgery early that summer and was not given proper time to gain strength. And according to these YouTube videos I have been watching, Karlsson has been working out like a fiend in order to make sure he's in the best shape of his life, and the results are going to pay off big time. Because using a strongman technique used to build up anaerobic and lactate acid conditioning, because Erik Karlsson, who is already one of the most conditioned athletes in the NHL, is somehow getting in the better shape. He's stronger. He's as quick as he has ever been, so at this point, we know the talent is there, so is the stamina, and the dedication to come back from an injury, and get in the best shape of your life. At the end of the day, he's going to need to push himself each and every single night. Don't take my word for it. Take the San Jose Sharks head coach, who said he came as advertised. To me, this is a huge sign that big things are coming for Erik Karlsson and the San Jose Sharks. He's going to have his work cut out for him in terms of the Norris race. But yes, I truly believe Karlsson can win the Norris and cement his place in NHL history. Roman Josi had a career year, and I doubt he replicates it again. But like it or not, Norris voters are more likely to give the Norris to candidate that has already won it. So I believe it comes down the wire between John Karlsson or any other defenseman like Cale Makar or young players, it will go to Erik Karlsson. Ryan Suter is starting to slow down in production. OEL doesn't put up the flashy stats. PK Subban isn't on a good team. You get the point here. No, I'm not saying any of these guys can't win the Norris, but when it comes down to it, the Norris is decided by the storyline. Roman Josi won it after leading his team to the playoffs. Victor Hedman would win the Norris with the Lightning after they had the best regular season of all time, but of course would get swept. The media absolutely loves to play up these storylines. And when we look at next year, who has a better storyline than Erik Karlsson? He could be averaging a point per game and leading the Sharks, the team that was third worst in the NHL last season, to one of the best records in the Western Conference. He may be discredited because he has never won a Stanley Cup. he may truly take a resume leap and tell everyone to shut up. I have always believed that Erik Karlsson was the few players in NHL that can carry a championship team. And in 2020 long, as long as we don't see another freak injury, I won't be surprised at all if I see the Norris in his hands. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you subscribe to see every video. If you're already subscribed, we all know you're awesome. If you're new to the channel, be sure to enjoy.